Dear learners, I am Sushri Sangeeta Saraf. Welcome to you all in another class of Diploma in Tribal Studies. Today we are going to learn about tribal society in transition. This topic will be delivered by our resource person, Dr. Nivedita Nath, a multi-talented and outstanding anthropologist. At present, she is working as an assistant professor in anthropology in Gangadhar Mehr University, Sambalpur. Her research area mostly focuses on tribal women and tribal children and their childhood. She had a great exposure to associate with the scholar from Germany and published several papers with them and had a dynamic academic profile. I am associated with her since long back, and I personally experienced her depth knowledge in anthropology. She is not only a good academician, but also a pure soul and a good human being. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for giving your valuable times to our student. Thank you, ma'am. And now I like to request you to begin this class.
Thank you, Sushri, for a nice introduction. I really felt motivated and encouraged nice introduction. So we shall start. I think there are only 7 students. So the students will join later on?
Yes, ma'am, they will join.
Okay, we shall start?
Yes.
Okay, so dear students, very good morning to you, and I hope you are continuously doing your classes through this Google Meet. And today we shall be dealing with course your course 3 and block 1, and your block 1 is tribal society in transition. And now I shall be presenting you the PowerPoint. Yes. Is it visible? The PPT is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today we shall be dealing with tribal society in transition. And in this particular block, there are 3 units. The first unit is tribal governance and polity. And the second unit is gender and class stratification in tribal society. And the third unit is intersection between gender, class, caste in relation to tribes. So let us start the first unit. The first unit is, as I told, tribal governance and polity. The objective of this unit is to understand the concept of governance, and also after knowing the concept of governance, we can know about now we can explore the different forms and means of tribal governance, and we can also know to understand the concept of politics, the concept of politics in the tribal context, and the nature of tribal politics, the changing nature of tribal politics in India. These are the few things which we will deal with in this unit. And as you know, India is a multicultural society, and people of different groups live in India. They belong to different social, ethnic, cultural, and language background. And in India, there is democratic form of government. And India is also a federal, India is also, is there is federal form of government in India. Okay, what is federal form of government and what is democracy? Now we are selecting our leaders. The government is of the people, for the people, by the people. It is the definition of democracy by Abraham Lincoln. And so we are directly electing our, we are directly choosing our leaders. We are voting, we are casting vote to select our leaders. That means the member of parliament and the member of state legislative assemblies. And we have a parliament at the center, we have state legislatures at the state, and we have gram panchayats at the village level. And this is the form of government in India. And but as I already told you that India is a multicultural society. People of different backgrounds stay here. For example, general class people are there, scheduled tribe are there, scheduled caste are there. Then people of different religions are also there. Around 645 tribal communities are there in India. So can a single system of government cater to the need of the people? Definitely no. And let us now know what is government and what is governance. Governance is a broad term. And government and governance, these are two different terms. Governance is a manner in which power is exercised utilizing country's economic, social resources for development. It is a manner in which power is exercised in a country. How it is exercised? Utilizing country's economic, social resources. And World Bank has identified three important aspects of governance. Please write down. World Bank has identified three important aspects of governance: the form of political realm and the process by which authority is exercised in the management of a country's economic and social resources for development, and the capacity of government to design, to formulate, to implement the policies. These are the three aspects of governance which World Bank has identified. According to UNDP, governance is viewed as exercise of economic, political, administrative authority to manage country's affairs at all levels. So it includes three aspects: economic, political, and administrative authority. So this is overall governance. Sometimes governance, the word governance is interchangeably used with the word government, but these are actually two different words. Governance is the act, governance is the manner in which the government really works, and government is the institution. Government in the institution, it consists of people, it consists of rules, it consists of different legislations, and governance is the act. I hope you are clear now what is governance and what is government. So, and when we come to tribal governance, earlier this this modern political system did not exist prior to independence. And how these tribal people were controlling themselves in case of any problem, in case of any conflict, in case of a dispute, there were tribal panchayats. There were tribal panchayats in each village, and it consisted of the elderly members of the village. But after independence, what happened? After independence, a unitary form of government, a unitary form of politics was developed, and according to which the whole country was governed. As I have already told, at the central level, we have parliament. At the state level, we have state legislature. At the district level also, there is a body. And at the grassroots level, there is local self-government. So actually, since India is a very diversified country, one law, one act, or a simple policy,
Ma'am, outra resume korantu PPT ja.
PPT, it's not showing?
No, ma'am.
Okay. इट्स विजिबल नाउ
मैम आपण हाँ एबे यस मैम
इट्स विजिबल ओके ओके यस So what happened in the beginning, there are no, since the tribals are very illiterate and they were not having much education and they are not interested in the political affairs of the country. They were living in quite interior areas. They had no interest to participate in the politics. Even the people were not casting their votes. Even all the people don't cast their votes during the election. But then comes the question, who will speak for the tribals? Who will speak for the tribals? Who will speak for the issues and the tribals? Then in the 73rd amendment, a particular percentage of seat was reserved for the tribals in the local self-government. Then their representation in the government increased. But what happened prior to that? How these tribal areas of the tribal peoples were administered? We'll see that. So first was while the drafting of the constitution, drafted certain areas as scheduled areas. The first category is scheduled areas. The term scheduled areas has been defined by the Indian constitution. What are scheduled areas then? Such areas as the president may by order declare to be scheduled areas. Such areas as the president may declare to be scheduled areas under the Central Act. That means the president will declare certain areas as scheduled areas. And what are the criteria? The criteria for declaring scheduled area are the preponderance of tribal population. That means there must be very large number of tribal people in those areas, and the compactness of the reasonable size of the area. In a very compact area, if a lot of tribal people will be staying, then that is then that can be declared as scheduled area, and that area must be underdeveloped. And if the area is developed already, then also it cannot be declared as scheduled area. There must be large population, and there must be in a compact area, and that area must be underdeveloped, and it is lower in terms of development, in terms of economic standards than the other category of people. Then the president can declare that particular area as scheduled area. And the Indian constitution adopted Schedule V, and Schedule VI, that is Schedule 6, to deal with the governance and administration of the tribal areas under Article 244. So Article 244 of the Indian constitution deals with scheduled areas. Please write down this. Article 244 deals with scheduled areas. And who is in charge of declaring a particular area scheduled area? The president is in charge, and there must be large number of tribals must be residing, and they must be in a underdeveloped condition economically. Then comes what is Schedule V or what is Schedule 5? The Schedule 5 of the Indian constitution was mainly adopted to protect the interest of the tribal areas. It deals with the governance of the scheduled areas specified in few states. I'm mentioning the name of those states. Those states are Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and Himachal Pradesh. These are the states where the population, tribal population, is much higher. So it deals with declaring scheduled areas or the governance of scheduled areas in these states. The fifth schedule of the constitution also prescribed how to administer scheduled areas and scheduled tribes. The fifth schedule also describe how the scheduled area will be administered, how administration will be carried out in those scheduled areas. So there is a provision of Tribal Advisory Council, TAC. Please note down it. TAC, Tribal Advisory Council for Scheduled Areas. under 5th schedule of the Indian Constitution. This may come as a short question, and not only for your this exam, even if you are appearing civil services, even if you are appearing NET, this is a very important question that according to which article the president can declare certain areas as scheduled areas. According to Article 244, the president can declare certain areas as scheduled areas. Who can declare, under whose jurisdiction the declaration of scheduled areas is there? Under president's jurisdiction, the declaration of scheduled areas is there. Then under which schedule this provision of scheduled area is there? Under 5th schedule, this provision of scheduled area is there. Then the next question is how these scheduled areas are administered? Now, the scheduled areas are administered by setting up tribal advisory councils, TAC, and it is under 5th schedule. Then what is TAC? What is tribal advisory council? The tribal advisory council consists of 20 to 25 members, 20 to 25 members, among whom 3/4 are ST members of the state legislative assembly. So a tribal advisory council ra 3/4 member tribal thibe. So that semane tribal area ra administration administration re involve hei paribe. And the objective of the TAC tribal advisory council is to advise the governor in matters pertaining to welfare and advancement of the scheduled tribes. These members of the tribal advisory council will advise the governor that this should be done, this particular policy should be there for the tribal, this much money is insufficient for the tribals, some more allocations should be done for the scheduled areas. Such kind of advices are to be given by the tribal advisory council. Then what next it does, besides giving advice to the governor, it monitors and reviews the measures to be taken for the welfare of the tribal communities. It also monitors the measures, the reviews the measures. Suppose livelihood scheme is started in a tribal pocket. So the tribal advisory council will monitor je seta lokankara kete dur benefit re asila kete loko taro subidha nelle actually eta village level re implement hella ki nai lokanka pakhare taro subidha ta pahunchila ki nai na implement khali implement hella policy hella but the people did not take the benefit ei type ro jinsa gudaka they'll monitor and they'll review. Then under this 5th schedule there is also another also prescribed another thing. The governor has sweeping power to make regulations for the peace and good governance of the scheduled area. The governor can make certain special regulations for the scheduled areas under this schedule B. What he can do? He can prohibit the transfer of tribal land. बहुत जगार कौन हूँ दिस इज ए वेरी इंपोर्टेंट इश्यू लैंड एलिनेशन ट्राइबल लैंड गुड़ाक नॉन ट्राइबल मैंने नहीं जाऊँगी फॉर डिफरेंट पर्पसेस दे आर बाइंग इट इन ए वेरी लो प्राइस तो द गवर्नर कैन प्रोहिबिट द ट्रांसफर ट्राइबल लैंड इवेन इफ द गवर्नमेंट जो जगह भी चाहूब गोटे ट्राइबल लैंड को नापाई फर एनी हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट फर एनी माइनिंग फर एनी इंडस्ट्री इवेन द गवर्नर कैन इंटरफियर and then regulate the business of money lenders. Say tribal area re jo petty business man mane thanti se mane kon karanti na lokonko uthu lokonko paisa dianti bahut high rate re interest niyanti and do different kinds of business by using tribal people and they buy minor forest producers in a very small in a very low prices. So all these things can be ensured and regulated by the governor if he wants. Then what the governor can do under this 5th schedule? The governor may also, after consulting the tribal advisory council, recommend the president for the amendment of any law made by the center or the state. The governor can also recommend the center to amend any law. So these are the things mentioned in 5th schedule, and the most important thing you have to remember is tribal advisory council. Then we can discuss about 6th schedule. As I told that the 5th schedule deals with governance in some states. I am repeating those name of those states: Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Nadu, and Himachal Pradesh. These are the states which in which the administration of the scheduled areas will be governed it has been mentioned in schedule B or schedule 5. Then we shall discuss schedule 6. The sixth schedule affirms that the governor of the state having tribal areas can formulate autonomous district council or autonomous regional council for administration of the tribal areas. But the sixth schedule deals with, please write down the name of the states in which can be done. The name of the states are Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Tripura. These are the four states. These are the four states, the administration of which is dealt with, which is mentioned in sixth schedule. And the governor can establish autonomous district councils in these states. How he will formulate these autonomous district councils? He will formulate these autonomous district council by looking at the social customs and organizations of the tribal people. If the social customs and organizations of a particular tribal area is different from rest of the non-tribal people in that area, then the governor declare as autonomous district under sixth schedule. The autonomous districts or the regional council has been given certain power to formulate the rules regarding those regarding the administration of those autonomous councils, autonomous districts. So they can manage all type of forests. They can talk about, or they can make rule for the development of canal or other water resources. They can ban jhum or shifting cultivation, and they can form power has been given so that they can form gram samiti. Then they can interfere matters like inheritance, marriage, divorce, social customs. All these matters, they can have rules and regulations in all these matters in those four states where autonomous districts has been formed. Then let us come to, these are the special acts or policies which has been made for the tribal dominated areas of the country. Now let's come to Panchayati Raj institution. As I have already told that the 73rd amendment, which was made in the year 1993, please write down, this is very, very important. It comes as a questions and all kinds of competitive examinations, and also it will may come in your examination also. And that which amendment specifies reservation of seats for the scheduled tribes in local in gram panchayat or at a panchayat level, and this is 73rd amendment. Which year 73rd amendment was made? It was made in the year 1993. So according to the 73rd amendment of the constitution, which was made in the year 1993, 1/3 of the seats will be reserved for the tribal communities at different levels of the local self government. Ta mane jette ta seat rohichi taro ek trutiyansha seat schedule tribe manako pai reserve rohibo. Sei seat ru kebala tribal community ro loko hi contest kari paribe. To it कौन हैला एक प्रकार रिजर्वेशन द्वारा जो ट्राइबल माने इंटरेस्टेड हो नथिले किंबा एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को आसी पारु नथिले एबे ताका में किछटा सीट रिजर्व है कि रहिला. सो दे आर बाउंड से माने जेमती हेले भी सही सीट रु ट्राइबल माने ही कंटेस्ट करिवे, ट्राइबल माने ही इलेक्ट हेबे. तो हमरो पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम रे, हमरो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सिस्टम रे schedule tribe mankar representation rahila. This is a very good initiative made by the government of India, and it made the root of democracy in India strong. Because what happened after this amendment, the most marginalized people, the indigenous people, the people who are at the grassroots level, the tribals who were exploited by the non-tribal people, they got the opportunity to come to the administration system. They could speak about themselves, they could speak what they need, which policy is not beneficial for them, which policy is beneficial for them. All those things they can do only after this reservation of seats for them. And for example, the government is trying to establish one hospital or one school in the tribal area, then the tribal can speak that, yes, we need hospital here, we need school here, we need this fishery program, this animal husbandry program, whatever may be, relating to agriculture, relating to industrial, anything, any, they can raise their voice in any poverty eradication program made by the government. So this is a very very good step by the government. Then we shall discuss about PESA. What is PESA? Panchayat Extension to Scheduled Areas Act 1996. Please write down it. It's also a short question. PESA. What is the full form of PESA? Panchayat Extension to Scheduled Areas Act 1996. So with the intention of enabling the tribal society to assume control over their own destiny by preserving their and conserving their traditional rights over natural resources, this PESA came into force in 1996. This act extends panchayat raj system to tribal areas in 8 states. It is also meant for some, not for all states, but for the tribal dominated states. Which tribal dominated states? Please write down. PESA was extended to the states like Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Gujarat, Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, and Rajasthan. These are the tribal dominated states of India. And the objective of the PESA is to enable the tribal community to save their traditional rights over their natural resources. What happened? The tribals were using the natural resources in and around them. They are using the river, they are using the pond, they are using mostly the forest in and around the tribal villages. And it protected their rights over these natural resources for which they are dependent for their everyday life, for which they are dependent on their livelihood. And then another act came, which is also occupies an important place for the empowerment of the tribals. That is Forest Rights Act. That is Forest Rights Act 2006. Please write down. This will also come as a third question. FRA. This is shortly known as FRA, Forest Rights Act. So this act was to assure the rights of the tribals over the forest land, and not only it gave rights to the tribals over the forest land, it also gave rights to the tribals for the management of the forest land, for the management, for the preservation of the forest in and around them. So this is all about the different different laws and different rules and different schedules were there relating to the governance, relating to the participation of the tribals in the governance system, and the special laws and rules for the participation of the tribals, for the benefit of the tribals and for the welfare of the tribals. So what happened earlier, the non-tribal people were representing the tribal people, they were the spokes, they were talking about the tribal people. But after this 73rd amendment, after PESA, after FRA, the tribal people could spoke about themselves, they could spoke about themselves. This was the change which happened in course of tribe. So this was the transition in tribal governance, in tribal polity. Now we shall discuss about these points mentioned in your course. I think political participation, who represents the STs, I have already covered that point. And constitution and political reservation, yes, I have already covered this point. And contemporary tribal politics. So these are the four points which will be discussed under tribal polity. Yes, I have forgotten one thing. There are also special provisions for the scheduled tribes so that they can participate in the administration of the country. According to Article 330, please note down the articles. According to Article 330, Article 332, Article 334, there are provisions for the reservation of seats for scheduled tribes and scheduled castes in the Lok Sabha and in the legislative assemblies of the state. This point I have forgotten to tell you, that not only seats are reserved for the scheduled tribes in the Panchayati Raj system, but seats are also reserved for the scheduled tribes in the Lok Sabha and in the state legislative assemblies. According to which article? According to 330, 332 and 334, seats have been reserved for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes for in Lok Sabha and legislative assemblies. Then, however, all those seats have been reserved for the scheduled tribes and scheduled castes in the Lok Sabha and state legislative assemblies, there is no reservation for the scheduled tribes or scheduled caste in the upper house. As you all know, in our parliament there are two houses, Lok Sabha, the Rajya Sabha, the upper house and the lower house. The Lok Sabha is the lower house, the Rajya Sabha is the upper house. So even if seats have been reserved for the STs in the lower house, there is no system of reservation for the STs in the upper house at the center. Because in the upper house, the members are not elected directly by the people. So therefore, till today, there has been no provision for reservation of seats for STs in the upper house and in the Vidhan Parishads. In the state also, there are two houses, but in our state, there is only Vidhan Sabha. In our state, there is no Vidhan Parishad, but in some of the large states, there is Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad in the state level also. State Legislative Assembly is one, that is Vidhan Sabha, and the other is Vidhan Parishad. So, in a state level also, in Vidhan Parishad, there is no reservation for the scheduled tribes in Vidhan Parishad. Then, because of contemporary, then the last point, contemporary tribal politics. Vartaman da samayare kon hochi? What is the contemporary situation in tribal politics? Sampratiko sthiti kon tribal politics re? Na, jodiyo seats have been reserved for the tribals, though there is PESA, though there is FRA, though one third of the seats have been reserved at the Panchayati Raj level, the government sometimes is also, I can say, exploiting the tribals. It is taking away the lands from the tribals in the name of mining, in the name of hydroelectric projects, in the name of different defense projects, and in the name of different developmental activities. For example, in Kalahandi, this Upper Indravati hydroelectric project was settled up by evacuating thousands of tribal people. Jodiyo government बहुत गुडे रूल करिची ट्राइबल मानकर डेवलपमेंट पाई तांकर इकोनॉमिक अपलिफ्टमेंट पाई समटाइम्स द गवर्नमेंट इज आल्सो टेकिंग अवे द लैंड्स एंड इट इज एस्टैब्लिशिंग एंड इट इज अलाउइंग द प्राइवेट कंपनीज फॉर एस्टैब्लिशिंग डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ कंपनीज एंड इंडस्ट्रीज इन द ट्राइबल डोमिनेटेड पॉकेट्स फॉर व्हिच थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ट्राइबल्स आर लूजिंग देयर लैंड्स थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ट्राइबल आर इवैक्यूएटेड फ्रॉम देयर homelands. And we can give the examples of those, that is iron core mine at Bastar, hydroelectric project at Hirakud, then Upper Indravati hydroelectric project which I have told at Kalahandi. Then we can talk of Pusco and Vedanta in Odisha, and this Sardar Sarovar dam in Gujarat. These are the few examples due to which many, I mean, thousands of tribals have been evacuated from their areas, and they were displaced from their areas. And in sometimes the tribal could raise their voice, and but sometimes they could not raise their voice, and the industry and the hydroelectric projects were open. But somehow, due to the revolution by the tribals, due to the raising of voice by the tribals, this FRA and this PESA, these two acts came, these two acts were came into force or framed after more than 50 years of independence of India because of the raising of voice by the tribals. The recent acts, the recent laws, the FRA and the PESA. Now, let us conclude this. This is the contemporary tribal politics that is happening in the modern India, in the present time in India. Then we can discuss Unit 3. And Unit 3 is gender class stratification in tribal society. And in this unit, we shall deal with gender stratification in tribal society. And we can discuss women in tribal economy and political structure, because women constitute half of the population of any society. If we are discussing about tribal governance and tribal polity, we must discuss about women's participation in tribal economy and tribal political structures. Then we shall discuss the status of women in the traditional social structure. What was the status of women in the traditional social structure, and what is the status of women in the present situation? And then this unit also covers your class and class stratification in tribal society. Earlier there are no class system in tribal society, but how this class system has entered into the tribal society, that thing will also be discussed in this unit. So so first we shall deal with gender stratification. So what is stratification? Stratification, the exact Odia word for stratification is storikarana. The exact Odia word for stratification, the word is storikarana. Yes. So what is starikarana, what is stratification? The whole society in the world has been classified into different groups, the whole human population has been divided into different groups. All the people in the world do not have the similar kind of status or view. They have been classified or stratified on different basis. The first one is gender. The whole population has been divided into men and women, into male and female. And the second thing is the whole society is again divided according to the Hindu society is divided into different castes. That is one form of social stratification in India, which is unique in India. But the whole world, there are different kinds of class stratification in the society. And so here we shall discuss what is gender. This will also come as a question of 3 or 4 marks in your course. What is gender? Gender is the social dimension of being male or female. It is a sense of identity among the male and female. Biologically, we are born as male and female, but we gain the consciousness of being men and women after some years, because of the social customs and traditions, because of our socialization process. We are taught to act in a certain way and to behave in a certain way, and that is how and we gradually get that consciousness that I am a man or a women. The society tells us, or we identify ourselves from our appearance, from our behavior, and from other aspects of life. Sometimes this gender is not synonymous with women. People think that gender means women. Gender means not women. Gender refers to both men and women. gender refers to both men and women. Gender is determined socially. It is the societal meaning assigned to a male or a female. Society emphasizes the roles which every individual plays, whether how the girl should play, how the boys should play, how the boys should dress up, how the girls should dress up. This is gender. So gender is used to describe the characteristics of women and men. So people are born male and people are born male or female, but gradually they turn this male and female learn to be girls and boys, and they grow up into men and women. According to World Health Organization, the learned behavior makes up gender identity and determines gender to two categories, men and women. It divides the behavior, it divides the dress up, it divides the activities. For example, we say that women should not go for hunting. So what is this? This is the gender behavior. This is the gender act which has been prescribed by our society. This kind of social inequality exists in all over our societies, and this social inequality has its base in social stratification. Sometimes the whole society, certain social stratifications divides the whole society into different hierarchies. For example, in caste system is a system of stratification, and it divides the whole society into four categories, and these categories are in hierarchical order. The Brahmins are at the top, the Kshatriyas are at the second, like this. So in a hierarchy it arranges, but there are some kinds of social stratification that only differentiates. So this gender is a kind of social stratification which makes only social differentiation. There is no hierarchy. Neither male is top position, women is at the bottom position, nor women, and neither men nor women. We cannot say that men are at top, women are at lower position. It is only a gender differentiation. It is only a social differentiation, but caste differentiation is a hierarchical differentiation. So this stratification, except this biological difference between male and female, all other kinds of stratification, that is your caste stratification, your class stratification, these things have been produced by the society. ଆମ ସମାଜରେ ଆମେ ନିଜେ ନିଜେ ହିଁ ଏଇ କ୍ଲାସ ଡିଭିଜନଟା ତିଆରି କରିଛୁ ଆମ ସୋସାଇଟିରେ ଆମେ ନିଜେ ନିଜେ ଏଇ କାଷ୍ଟ ଡିଭିଜନଟା ଆମେ ନିଜେ ନିଜେ ହିଁ ତିଆରି କରିଛୁ ଆମେ ସୋ ଆକର୍ଡିଂ ଟୁ କାର୍ଲ ମାର୍କ୍ସ ହାଜ୍ ଟୋଲ୍ଡ ଦାଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟିଜ୍ ହାଭ୍ ବିନ୍ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟିଫାଏଡ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଟୁ ମେଜର ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ସ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମରେ କାଷ୍ଟ ସିଷ୍ଟମରେ କ'ଣ ହେଇଛି The whole society is divided into four major divisions, Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. But Karl Marx was told that the whole society has been divided into two main divisions. What is that? One is the ruling class, one is the subject class. Please note down it. It may come as a question that what is the class differentiation made by Karl Marx? Or what is the social stratification told by Karl Marx? According to Karl Marx, the whole society is divided into two groups. One is ruling class and the other is subject class. One is proletariat, other is bourgeois. The bourgeois are the ruling class and the proletariat are the working class or the labor class. And the ruling class has the power of production, power of ownership, power of control, and the working class are only the service class, and they are oppressed by the capitalists. They are oppressed by the ruling class. This is the differentiation. This is the social stratification which has been made by Karl Marx. Then if we will come to the tribal society, what is the gender stratification made in the tribal society? Now We say that the women occupies a good position in the tribal society in comparison to Hindu society. But actually, if we'll go to the detailed lives of the tribal women also, we'll find that some rules and regulations in the tribal society are also against the women, are also suppressing and oppressing the women. In the past, I already said the tribal society is divided into two. There are two types of tribal societies, matrilineal societies and patrilineal societies. Matrilineal society, authority is in the female line. The surname is in the female line. Female line, the ownership is in the female line. And in patriarchal society, the authority, the surname, the inheritance, all those flows in the male line. Even if, then what are the matrilineal societies in tribal societies? Please write down the name of few tribes. The name of those tribes are Khasi, Jayantia, Garo, Lalung, Koch. These are some of the matrilineal tribes in the Northeast India. And mostly matrilineal tribes are found in the Northeast India. And and in the patrilineal tribes like the Ho and the Santal, since the women are not given the right to inherit the land, some women are found in the Ho and the Santal community. They prefer to remain unmarried to retain their rights over land. And if we also, if we'll discuss about the agrarian structure of the tribal societies, we'll found that there are social taboos which prevent women from inheriting the land. For example, in the Ho and the Oran tribe, women access to land is constricted by the taboo which forbids them to use a plow. Women mane longolo, plow mane hochi longolo, jothire amaro chasa kariba aguru jamin taku ta mane khola jae. So there is a taboo. What is taboo? Taboo means strictly prohibited. Taboo artho hochi pura puri mona, strictly prohibited. Jota gote bilkul jo category re loko kariya katha ne semane karibeni. Seta korle kichhi se family ra kimba se tribal group ra amongolo hobo. Emti type ra belief raithae seta hochi सेटा होची टैबू तो इन ओरान सोसाइटी इन हो एंड ओरान देयर इज द टैबू दैट द वुमेन विल नॉट टच द प्लाउ दे विल नॉट टच द प्लाउ दे विल नॉट यूज द प्लाउ एंड इन द टोडा सोसाइटी द वुमेन आर एटा तो एग्रीकल्चरल सोसाइटी रे कहली जोटा हो आ ओरान मानकर इफ विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पास्चुरल सोसाइटी इन द टोडा टोडा Toda have a pastoral economy. They are pastoralists. So Toda society, the women are not allowed to enter into dairy. Tankara mukhya source of livelihood hochi pastoralism, pasupalana. Aau dekho, kono taboo achi na women mane dairy, mane farm bhitruku pasi paribene. So if the women are not allowed to enter into the source of livelihood, into the center of production, then obviously they don't have any right on this production system. The empty bhabare dekhibaku gale the different kind of society different taboo rahichi aw women manku mona kara jaichi je semane eta karibeni ki seta karibeni. So there how they lose their right over production system. And Andhra Pradesh ra madhe semti achi women and in Andhra Pradesh what there are also some tribes, they are also not allowed to do certain things. And if we say about a pastoral gala, agricultural gala, ebe jodi ame discussion kariba hunting tribe dekhiba ame birhar hochi gote hunting tribe. Birhar hunting tribe re kon, the women are not allowed to do hunting. Women are not allowed to go for hunting. Women mane hunting kariya ku jai paribeni kimba hunting expedition re participate kari paribeni. Semane tahale kon karibe? That Birhar tribe is a food gatherer and food hunterer type. Birhar semane kon karibe? They will only collect fruits. Semane jungle ru kebala fruit collection karibe, edible root collection karibe, out tuber collection karibe, ghare randhibe, and they look after the children. But they are not allowed to go for hunting or हंटिंग एक्सपेडिशन तो सेमती भाव आम देखा जदि मुंडा ओरान सांताल आउ गंड ट्राइब जो गुड़ाक अच्छा से माने मध्य दे पार्टिसिपेट इन द एग्रीकल्चरल एक्टिविटीज बट व्हाट डू दे डू ट्रांसप्लांटिंग हार्वेस्टिंग वीडिंग रिपिंग हस्किंग विनोइंग है बट दे विल नॉट डू प्लाउइंग दे विल इरिगेट द लैंड ऑल्सो दे विल वॉच द क्रॉप ऑल्सो बट दे विल नॉट डू प्लाउइंग है एंड सो दीज आर द एक्स्ट्रा वर्क्स व्हिच द वुमेन विल डू besides cooking, besides looking after the children. These are the extra works which the women do in agricultural community, but still there are taboo that they cannot touch the plow. So these are how women are, the gender stratification, how the women are excluded from few of the activities of the production system of the society in order to oppress them. Then we shall discuss the last point, class. The last unit is your class, gender class in tribal society. Now I have already discussed about Marx division of class. How Marx has divided the whole society into two categories. And now let us see how one of the famous sociologists, Ogborne and Nemcoff, famous sociologists, they have told that a social class is the aggregate of persons having essentially same social status in a given society. So social class has relation with social status. And how they will get social status? They will get social status from their occupation, from their capability. And these Ogborne and Karl Marx, they have similar points of view. And another sociologist also is there, Max Weber. According to Max Weber, social class is based on economic relationships. Social class is based on economic relationship to the market, that is owner, renter, employee. So social class ro relationship kaha sahita rahi chi? Market sahita rahi chi? Then, as I have already told, with social class, there is related social status, the status of a class. For example, Marx jemti divide kari janti proletariat and bourgeois. Bourgeois man kara high status achi. Proletariat man kara low status achi. Kahin ki bourgeois man kara high status achi? Because they are the, they control the production. They control the production. They are the capitalist. So they occupy high status. The proletariat have the low status because they are the working class. They do not have any control over the production system. The social class sahita attach hechi kon na social status. And besides this ownership and control over production, ketera non-economic jinsara madhya relation rahichi status sahita, seguda kahuchi education, honor and prestige. Along with economic position, education au social honor au prestige ra madhya relation rahichi social status sahita. Then according to Weber, there are elite class. Weber kahichanti je there are elite class in the society. Who are the elite class? The higher class are the elite class, and they are known as social elite. They are known as social elite. So he has referred to this existence of elitism or social elite in the society. And if we discuss, these are the differentiation between the class stratification in the society. Now let us come to the tribal, what happens in the tribal areas. And because after the entry of money in the tribal society, this class stratification has also entered into the tribal society. And Verrier Elwin, one of the renowned anthropologists, he has divided the sorry Verrier Elwin, one of the renowned anthropologists, he have divided the tribes in India into four classes. Charita class re divide karichanti Elwin, depending on the cultural development. Tribal manakara cultural development ku dekhiki Elwin kona karichanti, charita class re divide karichanti. What are those four classes? This may come as a question of 3 mark or 4 mark, like your short question type of question can come from this. How Verrier Elwin has divided the tribes of India into different classes, or what is the class stratification done by Verrier Elwin? So Verrier Elwin jo division karchanti taku ame tike dekhiba. Class 1 is the purest of the pure tribal groups. Purest of the pure tribal groups ta huchi class 1. Who comprises of this purest of the pure tribal groups? It comprises of about 2-3 million persons in India, and this tribal group maintains their traditional maintain their tribal organizations, and they are protected and they are living in quite interior areas. The class 1 jota seta डिविजन एक नंबर जो माने अछन्ति से माने होछन्ति प्योरेस्ट ऑफ द प्योर ट्राइबल ग्रुप आ माने इंटीरियर एरिया रे रहन्ति एंड दे स्टिल फॉलो देयर ट्रेडिशंस एंड दे आर प्रोटेक्टिंग देयर ट्राइबल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने माने होछन्ति क्लास 1 सेकंड कैटेगरी रे को माने आसुछन्ति दिस ग्रुप रिटेन्स द ट्राइबल मोड ऑफ लाइफ बट सम डिफरेंसेस आर देयर सेकंड ग्रुप मध्य ट्राइबल मोड ऑफ लाइफ सेकंड ग्रुप मेंटेन करन्ति किंतु क्लास 1 टू एमाने टिके डिफर करंती कोन कोन डिफर करंती इंस्टेड ऑफ ए कम्युनल लाइफ दिस ग्रुप लिव्स ए विलेज लाइफ व्हिच हैज बिकम इंडिविजुअल इंडिविजुअलिस्टिक तो जो माने प्योरेस्ट ऑफ द प्योर ट्राइबल ग्रुप से माने कम्युनल लाइफ लीड करंती दे आर वेरी यूनाइटेड बट द सेकंड ग्रुप रे कोन आसी ना टिके इंडिविजुअलिस्टिक फीचर पसी गलाणी सेकंड कैटेगरी रो ट्राइबल मान को भितरे एंड आउ कोन डिफरेंस रहिछि ना दे डू नॉट शेयर थिंग्स विथ वन अनदर क्लास 1 ट्राइब रे समस्त भावंती ह ई पोखरीटा समस्तंगर ई गच्छटा समस्तंगर ई जागाटा समस्तंगर ई एटा मोर एटा तोर से प्रकार डिफरेंशिएशन न थाए बट क्लास 2 कैटेगरी जोटा सेकंड कैटेगरी ट्राइब रे कोन आसुचि ना दे डू नॉट शेयर थिंग्स विथ वन अनदर एटा मो गार्डन एटा मो बगीचा एटा मो गच्छ एटा मो गाई एटा मो छेली तो लाइक दिस दे हैव दिस feeling of individual ownership of properties or things. Then se mane kebal agriculture is not their way of life, kebal agriculture is not their only source of livelihood. Then the au kono difference roichi na they have been influenced by the tribe by the outsiders a little bit, mane bahar loko bahar hindu society ro sampark re se mane tike tike asileni already एंड एगुडा को होची डिफरेंस फर्स्ट कैटेगरी ऑफ ट्राइबल आउ सेकंड कैटेगरी ऑफ ट्राइबल भितरे क्लास 2 ट्राइबल्स भितरे दैट से मानकर इंडिविजुअलिस्टिक फीचर पसी गलाणी दे गिव इंपोर्टेंस टू इंडिविजुअल ओनरशिप एक्स कल्टीवेशन इज नॉट द ओनली वे ऑफ लाइवलीहुड एग्रीकल्चर इज नॉट द ओनली वे ऑफ लाइवलीहुड आउ गोटे जिनस होची दे हैव बीन इन्फ्लुएंस्ड अ लिटिल बिट बाय द आउटसाइडर्स बाय द हिंदू सोसाइटी बाय द पेरिफेरल सोसाइटी क्लास 3 ट्राइब क्लास 3 कैटेगरी रे को माने आसुचंती ना ए लार्ज सेक्शन ऑफ ट्राइबल पॉपुलेशन कम अंडर दिस कैटेगरी हैं दिस क्लास 3 ट्राइबल्स आर इन ए फेज ऑफ ट्रांजिशन ए माने गोटे ट्रांजिशनल फेज रे आसी के पहुंचिलेनी एंड दे हैव बीन इन्फ्लुएंस्ड ऑल द एरियाज ऑफ देयर लाइफ देयर सोशल लाइफ देयर इकोनॉमिक लाइफ देयर कल्चरल लाइफ ऑल दिस 3 कैटेगरीज ऑफ लाइफ हैव बीन इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द आउटसाइड सोसाइटी बाय द hindu fold of society e mane hochanti class 3 and what is the class 4 class 4 tribal mane bahut choto bahut kam kam sankhyak class 4 category of tribal achanti e mane hochanti bhil naga au gond raja bhuya emti kichhi ta tribe achanti santal and few mundas those who have totally assimilated with the men mainstream and they are owning a lot of properties and they are almost following the Hindu way of life to ei charita category re divide karichanti Verrier Elwin first is purest of the pure second is little bit different from this first category but still have some traditional features. The third is who are in a phase of transition. And the fourth one is belongs to very few people who are already transformed themselves and mixed with the Hindu societies. Eva Siva, I am another sociologist, G.S. Bhure. G.S. Bhure has divided the whole tribal society into three categories. The first category is Rajgond, who successfully come over and they have a similar status with Hindu society. And second, the large proportion of tribal society, who are partially Hinduized, our Hindu man ko sahita semane bahut close ko asi sarleni, they have come very close to the Hindus and Hindu society. And the third hochi hill section, those who are still residing in hilly areas. So eta hochi ghurenkor classification, almost same aluin chari bhagare bibhakta karichanti, ghure tini bhagare bibhakta karichanti. So this is the division of society between the division of tribal society by two famous thinkers, Viriyar Illuin and G.S. Bhure. Now, if we'll now let us discuss the last part, that is unit 3, the intersection between the class, gender and caste in relation to the in relationship to the tribals. A chapter ra mukhya lakhya hochi to understand these three types of social stratification. This is also a short question. What are the different types of social stratification, or what are the different bases of social stratification in Indian society? There are three bases of social stratification in Indian society: class, caste and gender. So in this chapter we'll discuss the intersection, the interrelationship between caste, class and gender. So as I have told, the tribes are in already in a transitional phase. They are already in a transition, and this phase of transition, the class system has entered into the tribal society. The caste system has also entered into the tribal society. And jemti caste system ta, it was fixed. It was fixed. The membership is determined by birth only. Eta tumara padha jaithibo already other units re. So I'm not going to very detail of features of caste and all those things. Just I'm telling in brief. The caste system re membership ta birth through ame paithau, kimba gote manushya paithai, and it is very fixed. One cannot change one's membership in a caste in one's lifetime. But class ta hochi gote open system, and it is achieved. One achieves one's class in course of one's life. For example, I'm a daughter of a teacher, so I belong to middle class family. But mu bahut bhalo padhili, and I appeared IAS, and I became I qualified the IAS examination, and I became collector. So mu ebe class 1 hei gali, mu ebe higher class ro hei gali. So I achieved high class. I was middle class. I belong to a middle class family, but I achieved a higher class. Now I am I belong to HIG group, high income group, because of my own capability, because of my own labor. So class system is open. One can change one's class during one's lifetime. Right, which is the basic difference between class and caste, and it is not fixed at birth, as I already told that I changed my status during my lifetime. And these two, class and caste differentiation stratification, has now already entered in the tribal society. Tribal society re madhya ebe differentiation hochi, who is rich, who is poor, who is middle class. And the tribals have also, because tankara neighboring society Hindu society, and Hindu society is totally within the fold of caste stratification. So the tribals are now also trying to adopt the way of life of the caste people, the Hindu people, and they are trying to increase their status. Tumhe mane MN Srinivas karo gote famous concept achi, I think tumaro eta already cover hoijibo, कभर हेथिबा बट स्टिल यू नोट डाउन हु कॉइंड द टर्म संस्कृतिजेशन और हु हैज प्रोपाउंडेड द संस्कृतिजेशन एम एन श्रीनिवास महेश्वर नरसिंहाचार्य श्रीनिवास इज अ फेमस सोशियोलॉजिस्ट ही हैज प्रोपाउंडेड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ संस्कृतिजेशन नाटा संस्कृतिजेशन बट इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विथ संस्कृत संस्कृत सहित यार किसी संपर्क ना एम एन श्रीनिवास कौन कले एम एन श्रीनिवास देखिले जे बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अर्बनाइजेशन इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड मॉडर्नाइजेशन ट्राइबल पीपल आर एडॉप्टिंग द वे ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ कास्ट सोसाइटी फॉर एग्जांपल गाधे की पूजा करिबा एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ जो ब्राह्मण माने अपर कास्ट माने पिंधंती पोइता थ्रेड हां थ्रेड पिंधिबा एंड जेमती की ब्राह्मण माने नॉन वेज खांतु खाउ नथिले एबे तो खाउचंती मदर ट्राइबल्स वेयर हेवी ईटर्स ऑफ नॉन वेज आइटम्स जेमती नॉन वेज छाड़ी दबा सो द बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ द कास्ट सिस्टम जो गुडा का हाई कास्ट पीपल से गुडा को से माने ग्रेजुअली एडॉप्ट करूचंती दे थिंक दैट इफ वी विल एडॉप्ट दिस हिंदू हैबिट्स हिंदू ट्रेडिशनल कस्टम्स देन आवर स्टेटस विल राइज So this process, M. N. Srinivas has termed this process as Sanskritization. Actually, say ago aogote term coin korithile, that term is also Brahminization. Please write down it. The concept Brahminization has been also coined by M. N. Srinivas. He first coined the term Brahminization. Kaiki na he saw that the tribal people are imitating the Brahmin people mostly. So he coined the term Brahminization. Kintu se jetele dekhile je not only Brahmins are imitated, but other caste people are also imitated, like Rajputs are imitated, like your Marathas are imitated in Maharashtra. To se emti dekhile je jo state re jo ta dominant caste, Maharashtra re Marathi, Maratha, Rajput, Rajasthan re Rajput, to se jo dekhile je डोमिनेंट कास्ट था राजपूत होची मराठा होची तो से जगह रे पीपल माने दे आर फॉलोइंग दोज कास्ट तो सेतेले से ब्राह्मणाइजेशन टर्म टाकू नै गले ताकू ये कर दे कि से आ गोटे नूतन टर्म बाहर कले सेटा होची संस्कृतिजेशन संस्कृतिजेशन इज ए प्रोसेस बाय व्हिच ए लो कास्ट और ट्राइबल पीपल इमिटेट्स द वे ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ द अपर कास्ट हिंदूज इन ऑर्डर टू रेज इट्स स्टेटस इन द कास्ट हायरार्की निजर स्टेटस को बढ़ेबा पई आमे हाई कास्ट लोकंकर जेतेले वे ऑफ लाइफ ट्रेडिशन कस्टम को फॉलो करूथाउ सेटा को कहा जाए संस्कृतिजेशन सो दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ संस्कृतिजेशन इज सीन इन द ट्राइबल एरियाज नाउ दे आर अडॉप्टिंग कास्ट वे ऑफ लाइफ एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अर्बनाइजेशन मॉडर्नाइजेशन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एंट्री ऑफ मनी इकोनॉमी द ट्राइबल्स आर ऑल्सो the class distinction, the class division has also entered into the tribal society. And so this is the intersection between the caste, class and gender in tribal society. So I think the chapter is end now. And we can have a discussion.
So I like to request our student, if they have any question, please interact with our ma'am or they can write in the chat box. Or maybe they have Hello. Any.
Hello.
Okay, sir, please.
Hello. Madam, hello. हेलो
यस सर कुंड मैम आपण को म्यूट होचे काही अनम्यूट करू को लेफ्ट हैंड साइड
पे हेलो
माझे सर प्लीज आपण क्वेश्चन
मॅडम सुनी करछंदे
हां सुना जाय छी
हेलो
हां हां सुना जाय छी कोंतु
मॅडम एक्चुअली आई मॅडम आई वांट टू नो द व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ द टीएससी TSC
tribal advisory council.
Yeah.
You are talking of tribal advisory council, which I discussed in while discussing fifth schedule and sixth schedule.
Okay.
Yes, I what is the role of tribal advisory council?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, actually tribal advisory council jota it is in the fifth schedule of the constitution. Au eta 20 ru 25 jana member ku neki heithae, 1/3 of 3/4 of which is which must be the scheduled tribes. Tribal advisory council ra objective hochi जे इट विल एडवाइज द गवर्नर द फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द फर्स्ट वर्क द फर्स्ट रोल प्लीज नोट डाउन आई विल एक्सप्लेन 3-4 पॉइंट्स द फर्स्ट रोल ऑफ ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल इज टू एडवाइज द गवर्नर व्हाट इट विल एडवाइज द गवर्नर द मैटर्स रिलेटिंग टू द वेलफेयर एंड एडवांसमेंट ऑफ द शेड्यूल ट्राइब्स शेड्यूल ट्राइब मानकर मंगल वेलफेयर ने आउ तांकर डेवलपमेंट तांकर उन्नति नहीं कि तांकर प्रोग्रेस तांकर एडवांसमेंट नहीं कि एटा एडवाइस करिवो गवर्नर को इट इज द फर्स्ट वर्क ऑफ ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल ओके प्लीज नोट डाउन द फर्स्ट वर्क ऑफ ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल इज टू एडवाइस द गवर्नर इन मैटर्स रिलेटिंग टू द वेलफेयर टू द डेवलपमेंट एंड टू द एडवांसमेंट ऑफ द शेड्यूल ट्राइब्स देन द सेकंड It monitors the welfare activities meant for the tribal communities in a state. It monitors the welfare activities meant for the tribal societies, tribal communities in the state. It monitor kore, todarak kore. Gote scheme manko pai heichi, se kete money ala se money ta kharcha hela ki एंड प्रॉपरली से ट्राइबल माने तारो बेनिफिट नेले कि नाही ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर मॉनिटर्ड बाय दिस ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल डायरेक्टली मॉनिटर द डिफरेंट स्कीम्स द डिफरेंट वेलफेयर एक्टिविटीज देन दे रिव्यू नॉट ओनली दे मॉनिटर दे रिव्यू जहा जहा आगुरु भी हेची ट्राइबल मानको पई स्कीम जहा जहा आगुरु भी हेची से स्कीम गुडा को केते दूर फ्रुटफुल हेची केते लाभवान हेचंती ट्राइबल माने को ट्राइबल एरिया रे लाभवान हेचंती को एरिया रे लाभवान हे नाहंती जदी लाभवान हे नाहंती कोन पई से माने लाभवान हे नाहंती व्हाट आर द रीजंस फॉर द फेलियर ऑफ द स्कीम्स एंड पॉलिसीज एटा होची नेक्स्ट ड्यूटी ऑफ ट्राइबल एडवाइजर सिक्स शेड्यूल जो शेड्यूल अनुसार ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी गठन करा जाउछि इट आल्सो गिव्स द गवर्नर ए पावर गवर्नर को एटा पावर सेंड गुड गवर्नेंस ऑफ द शेड्यूल एरियाज ए गुड गवर्नेंस पई प्रॉपर पई गवर्नर मध्य रूल मध्य करि परिबे The governor has the power to prohibit. The governor has the power to regulate the business of the money lenders. The council is that the governor consults the tribal advisory council. ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल तो निज आडू से एडवाइस दबो निज आडू मॉनिटर करिवे निज आडू रिव्यू करिवे But the governor can also consult, can also take the advice when he wants the tribal advisory council, and he can. The governor कर मध्य ये power अच्छी जे से tribal advisory
मैम माइक म्यूट इज
हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हाँ मैं ऑडिबल
ये
हाँ अच्छा ओके एक्चुअली मो लैपटॉप रु पावर सरी गलो सो आई कनेक्टेड टू दी मोबाइल आई यू सिटिंग गलो लैपटॉप टनी गलो पावर सरी गलो यस वेयर आई वाज टेलिंग अबाउट द रोल ऑफ ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल राइट
या
Yes,
governor from his side he can also take the advice from the tribal advisory council and he can consult the tribal advisory council and he can recommend the president about the amendment of any rule or law made by the center jodi konosi rule kimba law kari change the governor finds that this particular rule or law is not befitting to a schedule area in a state then he can he can tell the president, he can recommend the president to change that rule or regulation for that particular schedule area. I think I am clear now, and it will come as a short question. It will come as a short question of 3 to 4 marks. Any other question?
Actually, there is a confusion. Madam, suni korchanti. Hello.
Haan, suna jauchi, kuhantu. Haan, suna jauchi, kuhantu.
Actually, आमर जो 342 रे आर्टिकल 342 रे नेशनल कमिशन को जो आमर एससी एसटी लिस्ट तैयार हुए माने तो एडिशन और द डिलीशन दैट इज द रेकमेंडेड बाय द टीएससी और द नेशनल कमिशन ए गवर्नर जो आमको दिया दे गवर्नर एक्चुअली देबे तो टू गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया फॉर द माने अमेंडमेंट Then this recommendation is given by the governor through the TSC or the through national commission.
हाँ सेटा मैं कहली गवर्नर को पावर अच्छी से ट्राइबल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल टू सजेशन नहीं की भी से प्रेसिडेंट को से सजेस्ट करी पारी बे टू चेंज एनी रूल और लॉ देन
एनी
any public notification to exclude any tribe from the category of scheduled tribe seita madhya governor kari paribe that also the governor can do
thank you madam
ha yes any other question
Ma'am, we have a question from Chinmay. He wants to know who is monitoring the tribal governance policies and activities.
See, there is the Commission for Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe. There is a separate Ministry of Scheduled Tribe for the administration and for the welfare of the scheduled tribes but still this for example this tribal advisory council this tribal advisory council will look after the particular issues in the scheduled areas but there is the ministry of tribal affairs overall there is the ministry of tribal affairs which is functioning for the overall guidance of the of the union minister of tribal affairs and it is the administrative head of all the activities related to the tribals and tribal administration okay hello
thank you ma'am I have a question
yes
what is the impact of the statutory panchayat in the tribal area and do the tribal are integrating with the political political bodies or what is the status or what is the image of this political tribal area and the statutory panchayat
what is the effect of statutory panchayat in tribal areas?
Yes, ma'am. Or do the tribal are integrating with the tribal political system, the governance?
Authore ko question ta.
Ma'am, do the tribals are integrating in political process of government?
The tribals are after the 73rd amendment, they are able to participate in the governance process, because 1/3 of the seats have been reserved for the tribal yes. Manko pai 1/3 seat reserve hoichi panchayat level le, and because of this they have been able to participate in the different activities of the government. Ago jemti tribal manko pai non tribal mane kohutle, there are few non tribal people who are actually speaking about the tribal issues, tribal problems. But ebe kon houchi, the tribal are directly, they are at the grassroots level re semane directly achanti. Irrigation project ta tankara dorkar na nai, school tankara kouti dorkar, kou prakara school dorkar, whether the school is not only they are participating at the formulation level, at the formulation of the rules, not only they are giving suggestions, but also they are also implementing them, they are also a part of the review process. So mane nije kouchanti je this program is not benefiting us, this program is benefiting us. So after the 73rd amendment, the tribals are directly participating in the governance process. They are not only participating at the decision making level, they are also participating in the implementation level, and also they are reviewing and monitoring. But the problem is that the tribal people have not become so much educated as of now. They are not so much conscious as of now, and therefore even if power is given to them, even if they are in the system, not all the tribal leaders are active. Sabu tribal leader mane actively participate karu nahanti. Sethipai jodio they are at the level of implementation, still the tribal are not developing jetiki se mane develop hobba kotha, sethiki se mane develop hei paru nahanti. Jehetu se mane actively participate karu nahanti, they are not that much educated. And in some cases where seats have been reserved for the women mane actually elect hochanti, but the male are acting or behaving on their behalf. Male mane ta women man ko behalf re kaam karuchanti. Even in some areas the men are attending the meetings. They are called sarpanch patti. Kon na mu hochi sarpanch patti, what sarpanch patti na sarpanch kara mu hochi patti, I am the husband of the sarpanch. See asinanti mu asichi, the husband of the women, they are signing, they are doing signatures on behalf of the wives. So jodio that is the lacuna behind in our system, that jodio tribal man ko pai seat reserve hei ki achi, jodio women man ko pai seat reserve hei ki achi, though they are elected, though in pen and paper the women are sarpanch in some areas, the tribals are sarpanch, they are member of panchayats in some areas, because of the se mane eteta educated nuhanti, eteta aware nuhanti, eteta conscious nuhanti, so they are not able to participate fully in the programs. Even we can see that and they are not casting their votes also in the tribal dominated areas. We are also seeing very low rate of casting of votes during the election.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for an elaborative answer. So now I like to summarize. In this class we have learned about the 5th schedule, the 6th schedule, the 73rd amendment act of the constitution, PESA act 1996, the tribal forest right act. We have also learned about the gender, class, and the stratification, women contribution in the economy, political and cultural activities. We deeply understand the stratification by Verrier, Alvin and Gure. We also discuss about the caste system and the caste and tribe interaction. This is a wonderful session. Thank you so much, ma'am. And thank you for your interaction with our student. I also like to thanks to our listener who keep patience and listen attentively the whole class. I also like to thanks to our technical team, Amit Tripathi. Thank you everyone.
Thank you, Susri. Thank you, all the students.
Okay. I like to request to our listener, please give your feedback. And we will meet on 3rd June. Thank you, Sangamitra ma'am, to join this class. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Recording stop for me.